Taxi drivers at Minneapolis Airport have refused over 5,000 passengers because they were carrying alcohol. Muslim students are demanding separate campus housing. Muslim women are demanding separate hours in gyms and swimming pools. Schools are banning Halloween, are even banning Christmas celebrations. All not to offend Muslims. Ladies and gentlemen, be aware that this is only the beginning. We have it all in Europe. If things continue like this, you will have and face the same problems that we are facing in Europe today. If we, in fact, do not stop the Islamization of our societies, we will lose everything. We will lose our identity. We will lose our culture. We will lose our constitutional state, our democracy, our freedom, and our civilization. And in Europe, we are already in the process of losing free speech, losing the right to criticize Islam. And I think that to be able to criticize, the criticism of religions and ideologies always, always should be possible. And therefore, I believe that in Europe we should introduce an American kind of First Amendment. First Amendment, because the difference between the United States and Europe is very clear. And an example is the showing of the film Fitna that you just saw. A film that was not only banned in the European Parliament, and I was not allowed to enter the United Kingdom, but it was shown in the US Senate, when I was invited by Senator John Cowell. And in contrast of the European appeasers, it was possible to be shown at your own Parliament. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, there is one country in the world that has been forced to fight the forces of jihad for its values since the very first day of its existence. And this is Israel, the canary in the coal mine. Let me say a few words about that wonderful country that I had the privilege to live in for a few years. And since then, visited many, many times. I love the state of Israel. However, in Europe, being pro-America and being pure Israel makes you almost an endangered species today. But Israel, ladies and gentlemen, is a beacon of light in an area, the Middle East, that is pitch black everywhere else. Israel is a Western democracy, while Syria, Saudi Arabia, Iran, Egypt, whatever country in the region, are medieval dictatorships. And very important to tell you that this so-called Middle East conflict is not, ladies and gentlemen, is not about land at all. It's a conflict about ideologies. A battle between Islam and freedom. It is not about a piece of land. It is not about some land in Gaza, or in Judea, or in Samaria. Ladies and gentlemen, it's only about jihad. To Islam, the whole of Israel is occupied territory. They see Tel Aviv and Haifa as settlements too. And I am very much in favor of a two-state solution. But then I mean the Churchill 1921 two-state solution, when Palestine was partitioned into a Jewish state and an Arab part. Palestine, the Arab Palestine of today, is now called Jordan. And therefore, there is already a Palestinian state. With almost 80% of the population having roots on the other side of Jordan, with having a Palestinian queen, there is no doubt that Jordan is truly the state of Palestine. And I hope that the Israeli government will start telling that to the world. I will.
Yay!
Ladies and gentlemen, Islam forces Israel to fight. And Israel is not just fighting for itself. Israel is fighting for the entire West. Just like all those brave American soldiers who landed in Sicily in 1943 and stormed the Normandy beaches in 1944, young Israeli men and women are fighting now for our freedom, are fighting for our civilization. And the war, the jihad against Israel is not a war against Israel. It's a war against us all. We all are Israel. Ladies and gentlemen, like Bosnia, like Kosovo, like Nigeria, like Sudan, like the Caucasus, like Kashmir, like southern Thailand, like western China, like the Philippines, Israel is exactly situated on the dividing line between the Dar al-Islam, the Islamic world, and the Dar al-Harb, the non-Islamic world. And it's no coincidence that it's precisely this dividing line that where blood is flowing and where war is raging in many, many areas. And we have to get rid of this politically correct fallacy that it's all about separate conflicts. It's not. Let us please allow ourselves at least to see the big picture, at least to see that those conflicts all have to do with jihad all over the world, jihad in the spirit of Muhammad. Ladies and gentlemen, Europe ought to fully back Israel in its hilt, in its relentless fight against those who threaten it, whether it's Hezbollah, whether it's Hamas, or whether it's the nuclear Iran. Yeah. Also, because of its history, Europe certainly has the moral obligation to at all costs prevent another Holocaust against the Jewish people today. Ladies and gentlemen, however, Islam is not our biggest problem. Cultural relativism is the misconception that all cultures are equal. The elites, the political elites in our societies have converted this sick philosophy long time ago. Government leaders, even judges, churches, and union leaders, universities, the media, all of them are blinded by political correctness and have chosen the side of Islam. They feel sorry for Muslims. They pity them. And cultural relativism, in fact, is weakening the West day by day. We are losing a bit of freedom because of this cultural relativism day by day. Many of our politicians seem to believe that their job is not to defend our democracy, but to help to make the transition into Sharia more easy and as smooth as possible. Well, let me tell you, not all cultures are equal. Our culture, of our societies that are based on Christianity, on Judaism, and on humanism are far, far better than the Islamic culture. We should be proud of it. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm often asked whether I have also any answers to the problems that I'm giving you, and what those answers indeed might be. And I certainly have some answers. Let me give you a few examples of all the things that I already proposed in the Dutch Parliament that might also be good ideas for the rest of the Western society. First, I already spoke about it. Stop talking about cultural relativism. Implement an article in all our Western constitutions that says that we have a culture based on Judaism